Yes, sir. It's your boy, man. Y Dubs with the RND in the building. Man, actually, man, this is the second time I'm actually doing this for voiceover because I just realized that I've been editing these videos wrong, man. It's been messing up my quality. I've been converting it to WMV files instead of just keeping it as .m2ts. So now I'm actually doing this thing over, so, you know, I don't even know. Some of the points that I had in the last one, whatever. You know, they're gone, I guess, whatever. You know, PSN is still down, so Forms is still on some gay shit, so it's not that much controversy. Nothing's really going on over there. They're just arguing about who has the highest KDRs. You know what I mean? So, I guess I could talk about that, but I don't know. I'm gonna play some instrumentals for you guys, so you can rock with the gameplay. You know what I mean? Oh, before I even get into that, yo, on my desktop when I created this, when I recorded it, I named it R&D Power. You know, cause you'll see at the end of the game. You know what I mean? You'll see why, what I mean. You know. I'm not sure what I'm going to name it as I post it for YouTube, but you're going to see it, man. Just enjoy music, and if I have anything to say, I'll probably jump on or whatever. I'll probably most likely have something to say. So, but in the meantime, just enjoy the music, man. I'll holler at you guys in a minute. Map right here is like if you're defending against the right enemy, man, like this map is like the best map to flank dudes on, man. I think it's the easiest map right here to attack when you're attacking. I think it's the easiest one out of all platoons, out of all of the maps. I think this right here is the easiest one. That's the one that comes off the top of my head, but yeah, man, this shit right here. Yo, you can flank dudes crazy because they got ditches, you know, stairs, you know, hidden walls, caves, you know what I'm saying? All kinds of crazy stuff that you can flank dudes on this map, man. So, you know, and I haven't played this, you know, I don't really play this map too often. I don't get a chance to because I'm usually in a group. So, you know, they usually put you in third or fourth platoon if you're in a group. So I don't really get a chance to play on A&B, but... today we did. Some of the matches we were in, you know, so I gotta do those. Some with the repair kit killings, you know, some where we, you know, beat Raven or beat Sever attacking them or whatever. Got some of those to upload. I also got some concept montage clips to upload too, so be on the lookout for that. Oh, you know what I could talk about, man? Yo. Yo, check this out, man. And this is the thing. It's not even about this game, cause this thing happened in another game, but it relates to this game. How this game turned out. I'm gonna jump ahead. You know, in this game right here, you know, we ended up helping the other platoons. You know, as you can see, first platoon and second platoon is down, but you know the others are up. And you know, C&D actually opens up before us. Actually, A&B doesn't even open up until we leave the platoon, but you'll see. So the thing is, I was in this game before, and I was playing with this dude. I was OIC, and on this map, defending this map, and we were in ENF. It was, we had another clan with us or whatever. And the thing is, I asked, I said, yo, on the team broadcast, I said, if you're in ENF, you know, just help out G, get it back, because they started, they secured G and they started to hold it down. I got it on video. I might post it. I don't know. So I did that, and the platoon leader, and this is another thing too, when I'm OIC in the beginning, before I even continue, man, you just kind of effing these dudes up right here, man. This dude right here is going to come out of nowhere, man. He looked like a running back straight out the huddle. Mop. Nice. all right, let me get back to that. Oh, shit, man. That shit was funny, though. What was I saying? Yes. When I'm OIC, I usually ask dudes. I'll say, you know, all, you know, platoon leaders, check in with me. Let me know, you know, what's going, what platoon you're in. Who's attacking you, who you're up against or whatever. If you need help, holler at your boy so we get some people over there before the damage gets too much to recover from. You know what I mean? So, to coordinate the strikes and everything. Just have like a coordinated attack or defense. And I always do. I usually do that in the beginning of every game. So a lot of times nobody says anything. The only time motherfuckers say something is when they want something. Like, hey, OIC, you got a refresh ready? You know what I mean? This is finally after 15 minutes after they finally got their head down. You understand what I'm saying? So, whatever. So, in this particular game, the platoon leader said nothing. So, I guess once I asked the dude, the guys, I said, guys, just help out G. And when I say that, I don't mean everybody. You know what I mean? I expect the platoon leader and the squad leader to designate certain people. You know what I mean? Just to go. So, like in RND, like if we see, somebody needs help, sometimes we'll all go with the, you know, sometimes it depends, but a lot of time we'll decide on ourselves, like, yo, you go, or whatever. So I said that, and I guess a lot of people went, so they started to take ENF. And it wasn't a lot of, not everybody went, but they started to take ENF. So I guess the platoon leader didn't like it. So he got on the mic and he started, I guess he didn't like the fact that I was, that I asked people to go to ENF. And so he just said, don't listen to the OIC, come back to the platoon, come back to ENF, whatever. But he said it like very aggressively and borderline disrespectfully, and then he kept on going, talking shit and screaming over the airways. It's like, you know, I've made him a policy not to, argue with company members across the airways when during the game. I try not to do that, you know what I mean? So, but I mean, I'm just saying, like, the thing is, man, and you're gonna see right here, like, you see, our platoon is still down. ENF is lit up, and it doesn't look like it's going anywhere. You understand what I'm saying? 14 minute damage, 14 minute mark, half the damage is done. Like, that's a little bit unacceptable. Like, you have to, what are we going to do? Stay at our platoon and just let them sex everybody in the other platoons? And then when we finally lose, all we say is, we did our part, we held our platoon. That's some gay shit. You don't do that, man. You don't do that. If you're trying to win, like, because we all take the W and we all take the L either way, man. Either way. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, we helped out. Cause that's what you gotta do, and you're gonna see at the end of the, you know, how the game turns out. That I totally feel like if we hadn't helped out, they'd have lost. Well, not they. I'm sorry, excuse me for that. We would have lost. When I said they, meaning like they would have, like, completely. I was in my mind, I'm thinking like they would have completely just lost. ENF or whatever, or G or whatever it is. And you know, I'm not a psychic. Anything could have happened. I'm just looking at the damage done and the time remaining. It was half the damage done and 14 minutes left. You know what I mean? That's not a lot of time for the attackers to win. You know, so just judging by that, I was just thinking, like, we have to help out or we're all going to get a W. You understand what I'm saying? So that's the thing. And, you know, if you're against helping the other platoon out, and this is the thing, you know, this is the thing. Like, if only if you can afford to help out, If you can't afford to help out, then by all means, if your platoon, if the attackers in your platoon are pushing, then put, then you gotta stay in yours. You see, now I'm over here at G, cause G is lit up. You know what I mean? I go, and I'm kind of like off on a tangent here, but I'm just looking at the gameplay right here, and I'm doing a little bit of gameplay commentary at the same time. You see that guy? I didn't pick him up cause he had a repair kit. You see, I went to pick this dude up. I don't pick, if you have a repair kit, fuck you. I'm not gonna pick you up. Kiss my ass. I don't care. Anyway, you know, I'm helping G because G was lit up. You know what I mean? And we have to get it back. But what I'm trying to say is that you have to help out if you can. You know what I mean? Like, but to see with us, we were, our platoon, our bunker line was up and they didn't open our letters. So we were able to, we could come and help the other letters that we were able to. You know what I mean? Oh, this right here, I ran out of bullets, man. That's too bad for these guys, man, because they took me back to my old days before they took away my extended reach. Knife them, motherfuckers, man. Block them. Right in the gut, man. That's the gut. That's what you call a gut shot right there. Oh, man. But you know what? And that's how you clear out G, man. Like, how many people did I just murder in G just now? You know what I'm saying? And it's not no ego shit. I'm giving you the play-by-play commentary. You know what I'm saying? I ain't talking shit. I ain't ego. You know what I mean? I'm just saying. You know, you gotta do what you gotta do. And this is another thing too. You know, since we're on the topic of helping out, if we're attacking, it's the same kind of thing. Like when we're defending, sometimes I've noticed games where Sever, if they're an opportune, they straight take that. If they get the Roblox down on the gate, they take their APCs and they go straight to another lead and they stay there the whole game. You know what I mean? So now you got that platoon facing like five or six squads of Sever or whoever it is. You know what I'm saying? Like you can't do that. So it's to everybody's benefit. You know what I mean? It's to everybody's benefit that we help out. So this is the thing, man. Another, you know, if we're attacking, and a lot of times, and I'm not going to say every game, or, you know, I'm just going to say a lot of times, and I have Viz to show for it. RND will be, because this is the squad I play with. You know what I mean? Like, we'll be in a platoon, and we'll take it, right? And we'll do 100% of the damage, 90%, 85%, 85%, 75% damage, whatever. But sometimes we're in the game, and we'll do all the damage that, let's say, the other letters aren't, the other Valor platoons weren't able to get the letters open, or they got the letters open but they're not doing any damage. You know what I mean? But you know, we're doing damage. So if I'm OIC, man, or I'm platoon leader, if you know what I mean, rock with me. That's all. You know what I mean? Just rock with me. If I ask you guys, yo, you know, we're doing a lot of damage over here, you know what I'm saying, the letters aren't up, if I call for your APCs to come to our platoon, come to our platoon, just rock with us. You know what I'm saying? I know you know what we're talking about, man. Cause this, you know, it increases our, like, the more players at, because this is another thing too. Like when the defense, if we're attacking, let's say we're attacking Sever, and Sever starts to see that, you know, one platoon is getting a lot of damage, I know that they're helping out, because you'll be killing people, or you'll be getting killed by guys that weren't there from the beginning of the game. So you know they're getting helped. You know what I mean? So at that point, that's when we'll start asking other platoons. Just if you're an APC squad and your platoon isn't advancing strong enough, just come to our platoon. You know what I mean? Just come to our platoon and let's do the thing. All your squad leaders have to do is change the frag, or you guys will get points. Park your APCs in the back so it don't get blown up, and just keep spawning with us. You know what I mean? So the higher our numbers, the higher the probability of winning. You understand what I'm saying? It's mathematical at this point. Or, like, straight up, it's mathematical at this point. Like, so just rock with me, you know what I mean? Like, that's just it, man. Sometimes you have to help. I mean, that's the beauty of domination, man. That's why acquisition sucks a little something, because you can't really help out. You got to drive 1,000 meters just to be able to help out. You can't even spawn on that side. It's different if you can spawn, but you can't. It's the beauty of domination. You can help out, and they do it to us, so we got to start taking points from them. We do it back, you know what I mean? So if I'm OIC or platoon leader, just rock with me. That's all I'm asking, man. Rock with me. If you got other suggestions, holler at your boy. But yeah. And I honestly really didn't want to talk this much. You know what I'm saying? But shit, man, I'm a talker, man. You know, because I wanted you guys to like kind of listen to the music and you know, rock out like that. But I'm a talker, man. Straight up, I'm a talker, man. Yo, when I used to date, you know, I used to dominate my conversations, man. You know, girls used to be like, man, you know, you have great communication skills. You know, you can really talk the whole conversation. And I'm like, yeah, girl, that's why I'm different. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? You gotta be able to talk. Anyway, I'm gonna take a little break unless I see something, some more interesting gameplay, man. But something else popped in my mind. See, now I'm back at ENF. I don't think I ever went back. You see, I said I was gonna take a break, right? I don't even think I ever went back to ENB, man. I think I just stayed at ENF. I think that's where I was best served, man. Either ENF or G, man, because you know, the platoon we were playing against, I don't think they were all that great. I don't know. They, who knows? You can see that they're taking A&B right now, but because I think some of our guys are spread apart. But I think some of our guys stayed in A&B, though. In the beginning, I think a lot of us went to help out just to take the letters back and make sure that they didn't, you know, hold it for a long time. But you see right now, we got A&B, so it's not really much to worry about. I'm just going to see G's lit up. I'm just going where I'm needed. Just going basically where I need it. I like this right here. That shot right there, man. Because he's on the top. He obviously has advantage on me. But my hip shot is no joke. My hip shot game is official, bitch. Yes, sir. And that's the game right there, I think. Right? Yeah, that's it. Check that out. Now, you know, just remember the damage at the 14-minute mark. Like, damn near 50%. You know what I'm saying? Damn near 50%. You know? It's a minor victory, but a victory nonetheless. You know what I mean? Surprised I even got MVP on this one. Because I was nowhere near ALP or B for most of the game, but... yeah, now check this out. That's what I mean, the power of RND, man. Top 4 kills in the game. Several over, it doesn't, in the game. 70 plus. Cormac, shout out to Cormac, man. Cormac be doing his thing out there, man. You seeing him out there. He definitely does his thing too. The Busseteer and a couple other clan of, actually shout out to the whole clan of Valor Clan. I think there was a lot of them. I don't know if it was a lot of, but I know they were definitely in this game. You know what I mean? But you see, that's the thing too right there. They were in second platoon, actually. You see, that's the thing right there. Top 4 kills, 70 plus kills, top kill is 98. That's official business. You know, I can't lie to you. One time on the forums, I saw a picture of the old UPS. P. Diggy 22, Mojo, and it's Carnage. Each had at least 100 kills. I think Mojo might have had 140. That's nasty. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, you got to get respect where respect is due. And right now, we deserve it. Shit. Because a lot of clans, you know, clans do that, but not every clan can do that right there. Top 4 kills out of everybody, like even with all the several platoon leaders, it's official, man. Anyway, man, this clip is coming to an end. Signing out by Dubs, R&D, chill.